Most people in America are familiar with what restaurants and grocery stores must do with food that is timed out. As I look into this generic garbage can, I see a lot of opportunities to feed a man. I see a lot of opportunities for banana milkshakes. I see a lot of opportunities to feed people who are hungry. I see a lot of opportunities to give food that's still somewhat worthy to men and women in shelters today. Bananas provide potassium and other parts of proteins, sort of, but they still fill a man. I have a story of my late great-grandfather who allegedly sat on a dock to join the Navy and ate bananas until he was weight-worthy, and that's sort of marvelous of a story. Whether it was true or whether it wasn't, the point was he was a patriot and he wanted to serve. There are people that can be served by this food. I'd like to encourage all restaurants to do a better job with recycling with their leftover foods on people's plates, because old type of lettuce, old type of vegetables can be fed to hogs that feed our bodies when it's time to take them to slaughter. At the same time, there's a lot of breads that are made every day to serve clients that don't always come. Those breads can be set aside, and even though they're not great for geese and other type of birds, some birds do really need that wheat, that potassium that's in them, and I suck with nutrition. My late mother's estate was great at that, and I have siblings, late siblings, who knew all that. But there are nutritionists all over the land. There are people impoverished all across America. And when I see scenes like this, I think that company is not thinking what to do. Now, I don't want to destroy any human being's right to pull from a trash can to feed their family if they're starving. And I don't want to destroy my right to be able to occasionally pull something from my life or my family that's still worthy to eat. But the truth is, we still have to think about building that love box. That love box sits outside of a true trash can for a couple days, allowing people who are in struggle to pick from the love box what they need for their family. And it's not something being sold, it's something being donated and given out of love. And then when it doesn't make it, when it's too late, when it's too timed out, when it's too mushy, when it's too gushy, then it goes in the real trash can to our garbage collection cities, where we have all kinds of fodder being put out there in an odd way. But my hope for people today who are seeing this little video that's very simple, very strange perhaps, and just full of bananas and a little bit of other trash, that I'd like people to be encouraged to be more loving and kind with what they do and what they throw away today. Many things do time out, many things are replaced by what is new, but sometimes companies have to say, maybe we're giving way too much of this to this place and we could just have our driver drop it over at a shelter or at a kid's school where kids could have some extra food. I don't know the laws on this, I'll be honest, I don't know what's true, but what I feel is there's something being slaughtered here, and that's a person's right to have real good food for nothing more than a few cents on the dollar. And openly, I apologize to whoever trash can this is. I'm not trying to blast you for what's happening. It doesn't happen every day, I know, because I see this one regularly, but what I'm saying is there are people out there that could use this food. There are hogs and chickens and other things that could eat these things, even monkeys at the zoo. And openly, maybe that's a good donation to help a company who needs some good publicity for their company. That they're going to take bananas that are sort of suffering like this, and some of them are way too past their date, to a zoo, practically, to help feed our animals that entertain us, that please our families, that delight our children, and maybe that's all that's good for them. But I feel like there's an opportunity yet for these items, and maybe hogs eat bananas, I don't know. I don't think cows do, and I doubt chickens do, I know geese don't. But openly, there's still other opportunities for this food. Thanks for listening. In America, we have rights to know what's going on with food. We have the rights to know what is FDA approved. We have the rights to know why people who are suffering can't receive something free like this when it's thrown in the trash like this. But we do that. Many families do pass by a Aldi's place and find there's no trash can. And that's probably because it was feeding people who were impoverished. It doesn't mean the people are lazy, it just means they're trying to readdress their discretionary income and how they utilize their money. And some of this is still good quality and others of it isn't, but a person knows how to pick and choose what is and isn't safe to eat, especially if they listen to the Lord today. Thanks for listening.